What we gotta learn is how God trains us today. That's why it's so important to come to church, study, pray, learn. Because when you get in a tough situation, it's gonna be hard to call Brother Peter and say, Brother Peter, listen, I'm going through this, can you pray for me? I can pray for you. But I can't be you. You can't borrow Brother Peter's faith when you need it yourself. You can't live off of mama and daddy's faith when you need it yourself. Mama and daddy had to go through rough times. Then you're going to have to go through rough times too. That's God training us. Lastly, verse 11 says, no chastity. For the present, right now, seems to be joyous, but grievous. That means I don't like it. Nevertheless, afterward, it yielded the peaceful fruit of righteousness unto them which are exercised or trained by it. The word exercise is the word from the original gymnasium. We call it a gym, spelled G-Y-M-N-A-Z-O. It's a place in ancient Greece, ancient Rome, where men would go. It was like a basically outside court where they would wrestle naked. Don't ask me why, that's what they did back during that time. But it was a house where they would train for what they call calisthenics. It was palais, it was a Greek word for wrestling. And so they would train in this area where they would learn grappling, and so what they were doing is they were training so that when they got into a real match, they were able to withstand some of the exact same things that they trained for. Brothers and sisters, friends and visitors, if you learn anything else from this lesson, learn that God is training you. Amen. And you have to go through training, because the devil is not playing. The devil will put you in a figure four leg lock and have you tap out. You have to be ready. You can't live off of anybody else's faith. You got to train. And the way you train is allow God to teach you.
Amen.
That's my lesson for this morning. I hope and pray that somebody will be blessed by that, because I know some people are going through some problems. Lord says the same. Next week we're going to start from chapter 12, verse 12, rather than the end of chapter, verse 29. But this morning, if you're a child of God and you need prayer, you've been struggling, you can ask for prayer. But if you're not a member of the Lord's church, the church of Christ, not the building, but the people, the Lord says he's got one Lord, one faith, one baptism. You can be in the family of God today. How do you do that, preacher? I want to be a child of God. Because all these benefits, all the stuff I'm talking about, doesn't benefit you. All the benefits don't swell in his body. Well, I claim to be a Christian. I'm not a Muslim. I'm not an atheist. You can claim whatever you want to claim. But you're not a member of his body until you do what he says to do. He says, he that believeth and is baptized shall be saved. If you believe that, you can be saved today. All you got to do is come down these aisles. We'll stand up in just a second. Give your hand to me and give your heart to God. That's how it works. We baptize you. You can be a member of the Lord's church. You can have all these spiritual blessings. You can be trained by God today. Or the option is to do nothing and walk out and be just a child of the devil. And when you die, I wish you anything bad, but when you die, you are guaranteed not to be where God is. The only two options you have. Give the word of God, you've heard it already. Repent of your sins. Confess Jesus Christ to be the Son of the living God and be baptized today. Today is the day. This is the hour. Give your hand to God. And bless you. Let us stand.